YouTube, Edgar here, and welcome to Artifexian. Here you will learn everything you ever wanted to know about world building, and then some. This is the cross-section of the average human food hole, complete with lips, a tongue, and some teat. A consonant is a speech sound produced when the airflow through the food hole, or vocal tract if you will, is to some degree obstructed. There are three elements to any consonant: place of articulation, manner of articulation, and voicing. In this video, let's look at place of articulation. Place of articulation, or point of articulation, indicates where in the mouth the obstruction is occurring when a consonant is formed. Now, to create an obstruction, two bits of your mouth need to be brought together, the articulators. One articulator will move, the active articulator, and one will remain stationary, the passive articulator. Take the F sound in fish, for example. Here the lower lip is the active articulator and the upper teat are the passive articulators. The lower lip moves to the upper teat, an obstruction is created, air is blown through, and boom, you get a F sound. There's about 12-ish places in the mouth where the articulators can be brought together to form an obstruction. They are bilabial, labiodental, dental, alveolar, post-alveolar, retroflex, palatal, velar, uvular, pharyngeal, epiglottal, and glottal. Let's break it down. Number 1. Bilabial. Here the obstruction is created using both the upper and lower lips. In English we have 4-ish bilabial consonants. Ma as in man, pa as in pan, ba as in ban, and wa as in water. 2. Labiodental. Here the lower lip contacts the upper teat to form sounds like fa as in fish, and va as in van. 3. Dental. Here the tip of the tongue touches the upper teat. We have two sounds here in English, tha as in thin, and tha as in this. Number 4, alveolar. Here the obstruction occurs at the alveolar ridge, that bony ridge just behind the upper teat. We have a truckload of sounds here in English, namely na, ta, da, sa, za, ra, and la, as in nail, town, dog, sun, zoo, run, and laugh. Oh, and there's also the roll door, which I cannot do. Luckily, this guy can.
Ra, a ra.
5. Post or palato alveolar. So this is almost the same as alveolar, except the tongue moves back about a centimeter in the mouth. In English, we have two sounds here. Sha, as in shine, and ja, as in vision. 6. Retroflex. We have no retroflex consonants in English. They are formed by curling the tongue back in the mouth and touching the roof of the mouth in the general post-alveolar area. They sound a little like this. Da, a da, da, a da. As in the Hindi word for island, tapu, and the Swedish word for north, nord. Apologies, speakers of Hindi and Swedish, I did my best. Moving on. Number 7, palatal. Palatal consonants are where the body of the tongue is raised to the hard palate. In English we find only one sound here, ya, as in yes. 8. Velar. Here the obstruction occurs when the back of the tongue touches the soft palate at the back of the mouth. Again, in English we have two sounds here, ka, as in king, and ga, as in garden. Number 9. Uvular. Here the back of the tongue touches the uvula, that dangly bit at the back of your mouth. English does not have any uvular consonants, but they are widespread throughout African, Middle Eastern, and Native American languages, amongst others. Closer to home, French features a uvular trill, ra, as in rendezvous. 10. Pharyngeal. So here's where things start to get a bit weird. Pharyngeal consonants are articulated with the root of the tongue against the pharynx. Don't ask. Pharyngeals are found primarily in three areas of the world: North Africa and the Middle East, in the Caucasus, and in British Columbia. Again, I can't produce these sounds, but luckily my linguistically inclined stick figure friend is here to help. Number 11, epiglottal. As hard as pharyngeals are to pronounce, epiglottals are much, much worse. Epiglottal consonants are articulated using the array epiglottic folds against the epiglottis. If that's too much to wrap your head around, think of making a vocal growl type sound a la Louis Armstrong and you're kinda on the right track. Epiglottals don't feature all that often in human language, but they are primarily known from the Semitic languages of the Middle East. Again, I hand you over to my stick figure friend.
Pa, oh, pa.
And finally, place of articulation number 12, glottal. These are articulated using the glottis. Thankfully, my stick figure friend won't be required here as English has two glottal sounds. ha as in home, and the glottal stop, as in the little catch of air in the throat between and o in uh-oh. Now, this is the main consonant chart in the International Phonetic Alphabet, or IPA for short. For now, all we need to know is that the columns are organized by place of articulation. The active articulators can go on top, i.e. the lips, tip, body and back of the tongue, and glottis. And below are the 12-ish places of articulation. Finally, it's worth noting that this list of 12 places of articulation is far from exhaustive. I'm looking at you, lingolabial trill, but that's another story for another day. Stay tuned.
Good morning, Interweb. First up, apologies for this video being a week late. To make up for this, hopefully I'll be releasing a new video within the next couple of days. And if you absolutely cannot wait until then for more Artifexian content, click the yellow box to the side to take you to the Artifexian podcast. There's a new episode out, 2 hours on nothing but language. Thank you all so much for watching. Edgar out.